It's Veterans Day, and everyone should take time to thank all of those who served our great country. I say veterans today are more respected than those who returned home back in the 60s and 70s. Pete Hegseth is with us, CEO of Concerned Veterans for America, former National Guard captain, Fox News contributor. Pete, I say that the vets are more respected today. They are honored today, and they were not always honored in the past. Do you agree with me?
I agree wholeheartedly. The way this country treated Vietnam veterans was a shame. They were spat upon. They were disrespected. They were called baby killers. They were not welcomed home with ceremonies. Today, I was at a high school in Minnesota speaking to an all-school assembly, almost 2,000 students, and they revered the military. That's the way it should be. But in the 60s and 70s, it was very different. Our culture brought the full weight of their negativity on the war down on those veterans themselves. And it's just now that a lot of Vietnam veterans feel like they can step out and be proud of their service, and the nation needs to collectively pat them on the back like we are all the young guys coming home right now.
I think they should be proud as people. I remember during the recent overseas military action, Fox News had reporters embedded with the troops, and we did a lot of interviews with the troops, and the quality of those people was just flat out terrific. They were really good people doing a really good job. And I think we're honoring them for the kind of people that they really are.
I think you're right. I mean, there's no doubt that an all-volunteer military brings out a certain kind of person. So most people who are in Iraq and Afghanistan are there because they signed up and they wanted to go or wanted to be a part of a unit that was headed there. It was a different kind of military in the Vietnam era. It was a draftee army, so a lot of people were there because their number was chosen, not necessarily because they wanted to go. And that changes the atmosphere. It also changes the level of investment from the country. The country spat upon them because they cared. Today, it doesn't make it right, but that's why they did it. Today, there's a lot of people disconnected from the reality. 1% is fighting the war. Most Americans don't understand, but at least it manifests itself in appreciation that there are people willing to step forward and volunteer to fight America's vicious enemies.
Pete, I think you were a captain in the National Guard. You fought, yeah. I think, in Afghanistan. 2 Bronze Stars. Am I right? You did that?
Yes, Iraq and Afghanistan.
Now, I want to bring up President Obama is sending another 1,500 troops to Iraq. He says they're not combat troops. Are they combat troops?
We'll see. They'd be foolish not to open the door to any number of contingencies. But right now, he says that these 1,500 will be doing the same mission that the folks that are already there are doing, which is staying on base and only training Iraqi and Peshmerga Kurdish forces. But the problem is, Stuart, is that regardless of adding 1,500, there's still a very clear disconnect between the stated mission of destroy ISIS, and the president had declared that's the mission, and the capabilities we're bringing to bear. I had a special operator saw an email he wrote, how are we supposed to follow them to the gates of hell, as Vice President Biden said, if we can't even leave the gates of our base? And it's an important question. Boots on the ground are one thing, but what do you let them do if we're going to destroy ISIS?
Now, the president is currently in China. I know his travel is planned well in advance, but it is Veterans Day. It's November the 11th. And we've been very critical of the president, but I don't want to pile on and be critical of the man for being in China on Veterans Day. Do you think there's anything in that? I mean, should he perhaps be home in America on November the 11th?
You know, I'm biased and I'm partial, but I think November 11th is a pretty good date to circle on your calendar as the commander-in-chief to be home, to exercise civic rituals. You know, you don't pass along patriotism and understanding of what our founders gave us, the necessary sacrifice that underwrites freedom, without reminding people through ceremony. That's why I did the event I did last night. I'm doing another event in my hometown tonight to talk about what Veterans Day means. Sure would be great to have the commander-in-chief present. Listen, I don't begrudge him his travel. If it's set a long time, and he's got things to do to lead the free world. But being here on Veterans Day would strike me as a pretty common sense layup for our commander-in-chief.
One last one for you. If you look at a lot of English people today, you'll see that they're wearing, it's called a poppy. It's a little red flower, a poppy there. And you bought that thing and you've given money towards the veterans. I think it's a terrific idea. It's a really good way of showing your appreciation. I'd love to see something similar in America. What do you think?
Oh, boy, I think you're very right. We missed that after 9/11, frankly, and that's on the George W. Bush administration. There wasn't as much investment, a way for citizens to pour in their support financially, morally. You could volunteer for the service, but that was kind of it. Something like that. I think Americans would respond overwhelmingly to something that gave to veterans, maybe to fix the VA or toward the war effort, if they were able to contribute. In more investment, the better, Stuart. I think it's a great idea.
You know, Pete Hegseth, you served your country, and I think you're a good man, and we thank you very much for being on the show today. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Stuart. Really appreciate the opportunity.
Sure thing.